Hey, what's up, everybody? And welcome to Cooking with Kenji. Anyway, so the other day I tried to do a video and show you guys me actually preparing the chicken salad, and I couldn't get it off the camera because Windows said it was a read-only file. So, Windows, you're really number one. Anyway, so tonight what I'm going to be doing, I'm doing fried chicken and cornbread, and I'm going to be doing this in two videos. The first one is the cornbread. This is a recipe from Granny. So I'm going to set this camera up. We gonna get going, y'all. Get going. Okay. Since I was just touching the camera, my first batch of cornbread is ready. Okay, shut up. Because you're not ready. Okay, so what I have in here is a cup of cornmeal, a cup of flour, a fourth a teaspoon of salt, and a tablespoon of baking powder. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna mix this all together. I know some people sift. There's some things in my family when I was taught to cook that are just staples. That's Best Foods mayonnaise. That's Albert's cornmeal. Real butter, mayonnaise, and that I can't believe it's not shit. I just don't think you should use that. If the recipe calls for butter, put butter in it. And vegetable oil. I also think if you use a wire, whisk, like this one here, to whisk your things, there's no need for a sifter to sift your flour and stuff like that, because this is basically doing that. In my Nana's recipe, it did call for a little bit more salt. That is basically the only thing that I've changed to this. Okay, now right here I've got a cup of milk, and this is whole milk. It's not Slim Fast or Slim Price or whatever you want to call it. It's whole vitamin D milk. And then in here I have a 1/3 cup of vegetable oil and one egg slightly beaten. So I'm gonna get this going. Mix it around. Mix. If you guys are watching my other video, you know I tried to call APLA to see about going to the HIV support group. Why don't you guys watch that video and then you'll know what I'm talking about. Anyway, Janet did call back and she didn't have any information. So I just got a call from Brian about 5 minutes ago, and he is having a meeting tonight, but it's too late for me. I am already cooking for some homeless people. Like I said, this is the first part of the cornbread. I should say, this is the first part of a two-part video. The first is the cornbread. Now, I know some of you are going to notice that there was something that I did not put in here, and I remember a lady asked me, she was just like, "Hey Kenji, can you tell me why my cornbread is not sweet?" And I was like, "Well, what are you talking about? Why does cornbread need to be sweet?" And she's like, "Well, I keep making it and it comes out gritty and it's not sweet." Well, guess what? It's cornbread, not cake. Nana would say things like, "Sugar ain't got no goddamn business in cornbread. It's cornbread. Not cake. If you want a cake, you bake a cake. If you want cornbread, you make cornbread." Now, that's all I got to say about that, little boy. And I would say, yes, ma'am. Nana would make her cornbread in a skillet, which I think is really cool. But I'm not making mine in no skillet. But I am going to do it just like Nana used to. I know you guys are cringing and going, look at all that oil. Well, it's really not that much. What we're going to do is just coat this pan with it. Make sure we get it all over the edges. So this is going to be part of my feed tonight. Somebody asked on my blog, and I think he's a lawyer, why I feed people and why do I help people, because he did the right things and made something of himself and he's all this, that, and the other. And the reason I do it is because, one, I can, and two, it's what I was raised to do, and three, I'm no better than anybody else, and neither are you. So let's stop acting like you are. What I'm going to do right now is, Nana used to take her skillets and put them in the oven and heat them up so the oil was heated. I'm going to set this one right here on this and heat it up. I'm also going to look over here at this cornbread that's already in here. And that one's going to be a little bit longer. Because it still needs to brown. So we're going to let this heat up. This was the cornbread. I'm going to use this rubber spatula so I can get all the goody goodness out of the bowl and into that pan. This glass, it's a Pyrex dish. And it's going to bake in the oven at 325 for about 22 to 25 minutes. The next video, we're going to be doing some fried chicken. I've got a couple variations of fried chicken. Tonight, I'm going to be doing what I call the egg batter fried chicken. There is the buttermilk fried chicken, but the way I was taught to do buttermilk fried chicken is that you soak it in buttermilk overnight. And since I don't have time to do that, we're going to do the egg batter fried chicken. And when I come back in the next segment, we'll be doing the egg batter fried chicken. So remember, guys, when you're making the cornbread, no sugar. No sugar in the cornbread. Ain't got no place. Just like Miracle-Whip ain't got no place in nothing but the garbage can. All right? Yes, Nana. All right, guys. So when I come back, I'll be doing a little segment on fried chicken. I'm going to get this stuff bagged up and get it to some hungry people. Peace and blessings. Bye.